We're back once again beside the St. Lawrence River here in Montreal for the Canadian Grand Prix. The event first moved to a variant of this track back in 1978. It was won by none other than Gilles Villeneuve, the first Canadian to ever win his home race, and in whose honour the circuit would be renamed. If you want flat-out racing, you've come to the right place this weekend, as it's full throttle for 59% of this 2.7-mile circuit, peaking at around 210 miles per hour going into the final chicane. But that speed requires discipline, and there are more than a few close walls here just waiting to punish drivers with a heavy right foot. And I'm joined once again by Anthony Davidson to bring you the lowdown for today's race. Let's have a chat about Williams. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within that team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do. And that's definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, and Chen completes the front row. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Hülkenberg, Verstappen, Lucas Faber and Leclerc, Magnussen, Ricciardo, Albon and Valtteri Bottas, Kvyat, Giovinazzi, Sergio Perez and Vettel, Grosjean, Stroll, Kimi Raikkonen and Devon Butler. Norris and George Russell ends our grid lineup. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
You managed to qualify better than we expected yesterday, so let's do the same again today. Good on the power unit cycle, so let's concentrate on bringing tyres and brakes up to temperature. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch. is now enabled and will be available to use when you are within 1 second of the car ahead in the DRS zone. Teammate by 6.8 seconds. Reduce the ERS deployment, please. We need to charge the battery. Fuel is at target plus 3. Let's get into mix 3 ASAP. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. behind is 1.4 seconds. They're on old softs. Their tyres are 5 laps old. We think they've got 2 stops remaining. The time last lap was a 1:19.6. Gap to the car ahead is 3.2 seconds. Out in front. Green flag. Green flag. We're racing again. Box, box. We're coming in this lap. Using a small amount of time to the car behind, keep pushing. Box. Someone's come off ahead of you. There's a yellow flag ahead. Release. We'll be doing one more stop today. One stop left in our strategy. brakes. That was very risky. We could have received a penalty. To teammate behind is 20.3 seconds. Car behind on the medium tyre, our gap to the car in front is 1.8 seconds. Okay, clear. VSC deployed. The virtual safety car has been deployed. We need to keep a positive delta here. Slow down, maintain a positive delta. VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Ahead is 5.2 seconds. increase ERS deployment. It's time to use some of this charge. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Confirmed. Move was illegal. Return the position. Battery charge is low. If we turn down the ERS deployment, we can harvest more energy. Is 7.2 seconds. Is 1.8 seconds. We're leading our teammate by 27.2 seconds. Thank you. excess fuel. We'll be back on target soon. Don't wait too long to turn the engine down. Seconds. Some information on Hülkenberg. They're slowing down. It seems like there's some kind of problem with their car. George is in the pits. George in the pits. Pit now. Pit now. Tires. Front is 5.3 seconds. Thank you. this lap then. Come into the pits at the end of this lap. Leclerc is behind you. Okay, the gap behind is 1.1 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. Their tyres are one lap old. The time last lap was a 1 minute 17.6. They're speeding up again, so I expect they've fixed whatever the problem was. Managing your tyres. Manage your tyres. battery charge is high. Let's increase ERS deployment to up the pace. Gap ahead is 2.0 seconds. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. In this engine mode much longer. We're about a lap over target. Drop down to mix too soon. Good job, nice overtake. Weber is behind you. The gap is less than a second. The time last lap was a 1:16.3. Gap to car in front is 6.1 seconds. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. Behind, less than a second separate you. They're on old hards. Their tyres are 10 laps old. The time last lap was a 1 minute 18.3. The gap to the car ahead is 7.3 seconds. today, we're reaching a danger point with the wear on the MGUH. Overheating the engine will exacerbate the issue, so keep the temps under control. This is your final lap of the race.
The Mercedes team pulled out a fantastic performance today. They should be proud. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
So after a magnificent race, we can now see the drivers making their way to the podium. Once again, it's the Silver Arrows who take top spot, a well-earned victory for Mercedes. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. Lewis Hamilton takes over the lead of the Driver's Championship after an excellent result. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for Driver of the Day?
That's got to be the Flying Finn. Wait, how many Flying Finns have we had now? Anyway, I'm talking about Bottas this time. Just great raw speed and a good job in traffic as well.
Let's move on to the Constructors. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.
Great workout there today. Let's have your thoughts. We all underestimated you, didn't we? Do you have any comments about the collisions? Judging from today's race, it must be pretty hard to fend off Devon when he wants to pass. There wasn't much between you and Lucas by the finish today. Well, that's everything.